We chose 20 young single mothers from the Viewfort district. They from Latony, Bruceville, Viewfort proper, but just the Viewfort district. And in choosing them, we looked at their background. Despite the fact that they're all registered with the roving caregivers, but we had to ensure that we chose those that really needed the assistance. And we chose them to be able to empower them and allow them to see themselves in a different light. Be able to see that they can progress despite the fact that they probably have 5 or 4 kids or without a job, unemployed, but they can progress. They need to start thinking about themselves and start making positive decisions with regards to their lives and what they want, setting their goals. The program lasted, well, today's the end, 3 days. The first 2 days we had life skills. So we had self-awareness, interpersonal skills, mind and attitude change, mindset and attitude change. We had goal setting the second day and dress etiquette. And today we're having our last session with them. Miss Janie Joseph is doing that session with them, basically trying to find out what have they learned in moving forward, how do they feel about the program, how they feel about themselves.
I think it is necessary that we do this final presentation before you go off and do your thing. You look lovely, by the way.
Thank you very much.
So the presentation was self-management, right, and the progressive woman. The girls had gone through a number of presentations before that spoke to themselves, their abilities, and some skills that they would need to be able to be the progressive people that we want them to be. And so this one was putting it all together, getting them to come to an understanding and acceptance of who they are.
One day you get up and you realize, oh my gosh, this is not just a stool, this is a whole pot of gold.
What if you were sitting on a pot of gold that you call a stool, and connected this to the reality that sometimes we are more than what we think we are. So it would always be a pot of gold, whether you call it a stool or not, in the same way that they will always be powerful, whether they tap into that power or not. And if they know that, then it's powerful to them.
People been talking about it. We won't just stand here in silence. Can't stop the fire from rising, rising. Oh,
people, don't you be afraid. So many innocent slain. This is an era for change, change.
So I think it liberated them and it gave them the permission to be. It didn't matter what the circumstances of their lives were, what mistakes that they had made before, but it gave them the permission to be. So that excited them. Towards the end, I asked them whether I was just speaking a whole lot of strange stuff into their heads and so on. And they were, no. They felt that they benefited. They were particularly happy that they learned that there are things that you can't control and it's okay to surrender to those things, because they were holding on. We are, not just them, we are all holding on to things outside of our control. Recognizing that it's okay to let go of those things is very, very empowering.
Empowerful, there's so much strength in you and me. Powerful.
find any human. And stars are the only thing shooting, shooting.
One of the young ladies that really, from the onset, when I interacted with her, when I first saw her, she was like, "Kisa, soka veya." And I said, "What's wrong with you, my love?" And she looked at me like, you know, like she expected me probably to give her that same reaction. And then I just said, you know what, I'm going to stick by her. And then from then on, I stuck with her. And by after we had this first day of registration, the following day when we met the first day of the program, she was really simmered. And I was really shocked. I was like, that's not the same young lady. And then she came up to me and said, "Miss, how you doing?" You know, she immediately opened up, and there were others also that you saw that reaction. But the very first day, one of the discussions, Pastor Dalston Morion's session, I really don't know what this pastor did, but the young ladies after that session, they didn't want him to leave. They asked for prayers, all kinds of things, and they just opened up. They just opened up completely. The following day, those young ladies were taking notes and they were participating, and they, you would have sworn that they had been there for like an entire week. And it was really, really surprising. There are some of them that we still need to work with very closely, but I have seen great change.
My big cup is on point, Jim. Thank you.
All right, so you can go ahead. Let's start with name, designation, and then talk to us about the significance of this event here today.
Okay. Marcia Dolor-Lashley, Youth and Sports Officer. The role that the Department of Youth Development and Sports played was very significant because we're dealing with young people. One of the mandates of the Department of Youth Development and Sports is to ensure that young people are developed holistically. And finding this avenue with the CEC, being part of the CEC, we actually try to spearhead certain aspects of this program, dealing with the letters we sent from our offices to make sure that we try to get some level of sponsorship. We assisted more or less in facilitating certain goals with the young people, with our training as build trainers, myself and Silvina James. We actually helped with the probably the ice, breaking of the ice, and probably some energizer, getting the young people to focus on what the presenters were going to present. And I think we played, the department would be pleased to know that we have a cadre of young people who were disadvantaged and who are looking to go into different fields now. We look at persons who are unemployed, and we'll be able to probably come around to some form of employment or further their education in certain fields. But we know that within the next 5 years, when we look at these young people, we're hoping that their atmosphere would have changed, their mindset would have changed, and they would be part of the life in society so that we can have a different set of young people coming out of the Viewfort area.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Parents.
Good afternoon.
Never give up on anything. Always try for best. Never make no one keep you down.
Success begins in the mind.
Simple is not easy. Simple is not easy.
We dealt with young people who were either teenage parents, or they might have gone through some abuse, some level of abuse, and it has been a challenge for them, being pregnant, and not being able to fend or make do for yourself.
People's opinion don't matter.
Always keep your head up high.
You don't want anybody to speak to you or to handle your situation. You wouldn't let go or open up to people because you know that somewhere along the line, some adult might have failed you. But we were able to actually break that ice with them
to be able to get them to come out, open up, and to be able to reach to today so that they can actually go through that makeover and be able to see themselves, that they're not the leftovers of young people within the society, that there's some move, there's something that they possess and that it can be utilized so that they in turn can become better persons.
Do not envy the works of others, for you may not have known where they have been through to get where they are today.
Have faith in everything you do. Have faith in everything you do.
The same old thinking brings the same old results.
Is that it? Yes.
And each of them have stated that they want to be better persons. They want to be more than just an individual in the society, not working unemployed. But they want to be able to go back to school, further their education, and then have gainful and decent employment.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The program doesn't end there. It's actually the commencement of things to come. And we will be identifying mentors for each of the young ladies. We will be approaching various agencies, example NELU and NAPS now, to assist in further educating them. We will be continuing the life skills sessions with them and just continuing along the journey with them. So we will be there with them every step of the way to ensure that they do not falter by the wayside because they think that, okay, the 3 days done and then we just leave them alone. No, we will be there with them through that journey. I must say on behalf of the team, the committee, a big thank you to the persons who came out. We approached certain persons, Pastor Dalston Morion, Dr. Franklin Bray, Mr. Charmaine Hippolyte, Dr. Urban Seraphin, and then we had two of our CEC members, the Community Enhancement Committee, Ms. Jenny Joseph and Mrs. Gillian Kodra. They are our facilitators, and we were indeed pleased with the sessions that they led. Then we had sponsors, because we were not fully sponsored, and other persons came on board, like Mr. Ron Steven, Mr. Omar Davis, the Library Credit Union, the Beaufort Police Station, Mr. Harris at Harris Brokerage, Ms. Toy Lawrence, and several other persons who donated clothing items, like Ms. Audrey and community members who brought in clothing items to assist the young ladies. And then we had Ms. Jeannie Steven.
Hi, I'm Jeannie Steven, owner of Hair Salon 2000 and also the facilitator for JBS School of Cosmetology. Today I am with my young ladies from the NELU group. There are about six of them. They are doing CVQ level 2 and they've decided to give their time. And also, so the two things that we're presently doing is we're doing the hairstyles and also we're doing the makeup.
And she actually thought that she was doing 8 ladies. And then here it was that 18 young ladies came to her salon and she did not say no. She called all the staff members immediately and started working. And then my past classmate at secondary school, Miss Stacy Ford, I call her up also and she came in to assist with the makeup. So within a week and days, a few days, we were able to pull this activity together with the help of all those persons and even more. We have interns at probations, human services, social transformation. They're also here to assist us.
Some of them have gone through really tough challenges in life, and they probably just need, you know, probably a little love, a little support, someone to really show them that we do care. And that is why we're here.
Excellent. You ended it for rhyme. Appreciate it.
You're welcome.